We saw our moms go through shit with our dad. You're talking about, oh, well, you're never gonna get married. Okay, my mom got married and she served my dad hands and feet and she ended up divorcing him because she was sick of his ass.
Because
it's only so much you can take.
It's not even just take. You just get tired. You get burnt out for constantly having to care for someone like they're your child.
Literally, I do not remember my mom ever eating.
Which is
she cooked dinner for my mom, for my dad, for my sister, and for me. And I can't recall a moment when my mom sat down to eat. Because she was eating while cooking for us because she didn't have the time. You think that I'm going to do that?
That's sad. As a child, looking at your mom, that's sad to witness.
You need to understand why I'm such a savage and why I'm so angry. You know what I'm saying? Thankfully, I have a boyfriend that understands, that's considerate of me, that knows that if I cook and sometimes I want to serve him, I'll serve him. Right. But sometimes when I say, yo, the food is ready, come get it, he has no problem.
He knows what that means.
And then after that, he goes and washes the dishes to help me out.
Because it's an equal partnership. One hand washes the other. It's not give, and then you just take. But that's not how it works.
Well, what happened? I thought that they were talking about how these women were so submissive, how they were getting all of this. This is what they want, right? But this woman said this is why she's so angry and she's a savage. This is what she says. And now I understand why the passport bros are tired on this land. Because what they're wanting is they're wanting a mat, not a mate. And they're going from community to community, burning all of these bridges and finding out that women have choices, women have options, and they have autonomy. But this is, they said that they're not doing it. They don't want to do it. Look at her. She's serious about it too. Eyebrows furrowed and everything. They are not playing. She never saw her mother eat. And listen, I can attest that I have been in Latino households where that is just their whole existence. I mean, it was such a good deal for men. Think about it. You get old enough, you make a little bit of money. Women can't have bank accounts. They can't work. They can't make their own money. They can't go anywhere. It's a good deal. You get to marry a maid. So you get all your cooking and a person to jump up and down on in the middle of the night. Don't care about her pleasure. Be able to bust a few kids out into the world. You could be mean. You don't have to communicate. You don't even have to come home. You could come home in a drunken rage and break everything up and she still has to stay. But now that women have choices and they have options, a lot of men don't know how to deal. They wanted to transition into women that they felt were more traditionally raised. So they've gone from community to community, burning bridges, looking for the most marginalized group, the women who didn't have movement and didn't have autonomy. And as these women are now coming into their awakening, they're demanding more as well. And this is why part of the reason that some of these men are just taking out their passport, because they're looking for desperate women. They're looking for women who can't do better. They're looking for women who do not have mobility. That's what they're looking for. And so they went from community to community here in the United States. And as women become more empowered, they become further and further disempowered because they had a good deal before. You marry a person who's a maid, you could treat her and do her however. You heard the Nigerian grandpa and how he said he treated his wife, grandma, back in the day. How he would beat her. And he was like, not even regular beatings. These were beat. And I was like, God,